session, we also have another planning session. And after that, we have the post-planning session, so you can know how to understand the whole planning structure there. And before that, I also send the planning material in the Telegram group, so you can also get some update and all the information there. Today, we're not only talk about the pre-planning, but also we're going to talk about UI direction and all like the direction, how to moving forward. So like the in during the RPM, we also have some functional direction. So yeah, we still will have a quick checking since we have few people, we can also, yeah, have a quick checking and maybe I can check in together. So rate from 1 to 10, how excited to become an MCP like the in July or June, no matter when you start your term. So you can rate from 1 to 10 and you can do check-in. So everyone can open your mic and speak. The first one I'll tag Raka because right now I'm in India.
Wait, so just I have to just tell out of 1 to 10 how excited I am.
Yeah, if you are really worried, you can also say what you are worried about and what is something in your mind.
Right. No, I'm very much excited for the coming months. So I'll give it a 10 to 10 because we have our conference coming up in June end. So a lot of preparations even for that. And we're also planning on calling a few past alumni and board members and whatnot. So it's all very exciting right now. So yeah, 10 on 10. Looking forward to it.
Thank you, Raghav. We can tag next person.
Eco, you can go ahead.
Hey, Eco.
Okay, guys. I have another double meeting with the MC. And yeah, I think if I would rate myself in terms of my excitement, I could say about 8 because you know my team are very like very baby, so they're like I would like to actually leading them. And then like they are very excited from start as what I can see from the transition, and then like they're asking a lot of things that actually related to their function and also like MC experience. And then what else, like I've been preparing about like the planning tools, and then like having some kind of routine check point with them in terms of their transition and also their understanding and knowledge before we started the planning. And then the next one, I think, because I could say that I have another people in my current team which actually being MCP, so that I have another support system, which Demi. And then what else? I think because we actually reactivate our physical conference, and then like the excitement from the members, and then like they mostly somehow sending me some kind of sweet message in order to make me more excited and also more motivated in terms of being MCP. So yeah, I think I am very excited, but somehow I'm still worried about like how can I manage this big entity. I mean, I never imagined to be MCP back then, and then like I need to be able to handle this kind of problem and also challenges in my entity. So that's all from me, and I would nominate Yuya.
Hello, and my score is 8 because actually it has already been a month since the term started in ICK Japan, and actually it was low at first because I was really worried to do everything. But I'm gradually becoming more and more aware of being an MCP, and now I want to do more in my term. So yeah, I'm so excited. So next I'll tag Kanel.
Hi, so I'm not sure how well you can hear me at the moment. So I suppose my excitement in 1 to 10 is around an 8. I'm not exactly sure why, but I'm really looking forward to it. I just announced my team as well and had our first MCM. And looking forward, and obviously the situation right now in Sri Lanka is very uncertain as well. So it's a very exciting time to be an MCP. Yeah.
Well, thank you, Kanil. Yeah, I'm sorry if rest of people still want to share. You can tag your name there. But if no, we're moving forward for our topic because we also have some planning and some important topic to go and deliver. So I hope you enjoy our thing, and we have more MC to come here. Welcome everyone. So yeah, let's officially and kickstart our session. So Lisa, we have two topics there, but before you begin, Mary can give me the sharing permission so I can share the screen there. Yeah, I'm trying to use my technique to use the iPad to share it because right now my laptop is broken. I hope it can be back during RBA. Cool, I can share the screen. So like the 3, 2, 1, yes, start the screen sharing. So we can officially start our RBN, the session one. The first one will be the EY keynote. So yeah, also let you know for information, I'm also the EY, like the responsible person for global, like the AI office. So if you do have any question regarding EY, you can also let me know what you think, any question in your mind. And please let me know, can you see my screen right now? If you can, give me the thumbs up and I'll know. Kanil, I'm looking at you. So yeah, okay, amazing. Because you are only showing my, like, your face in my screen there. So welcome to this amazing function, like the EY we are going to talk. So before we begin, this keynote session will take around 20 minutes and the rest of the 1 hour, we are going to talk about pre-planning. So while we receive the information from this session, the first of all is visual context for EY and second is the current global direction. Final thing, what should be aware of the EY during your planning? So yeah, these are things you can take some notes. If no matter which entity you're running for EY as the majority, or even right now you're considering about like the starting running EY. So these are two information you can keep in your mind, how you bring these context back to your planning things there. So yeah, moving to the next. So first of all, we're looking to the regional context consolidation based on last whole year, what APD. So we have 7 entities running for GSP, engaged with the 2080 youth engagement and 43 partners engagement. And National EY Initiative AP take the lead, and also we engage most of the young people compared to other region. We have 24K like the young people engaged, and also 613 partners engagement. And 3 is coming from Heading for Future, coming from Sri Lanka, India, and also Australia. It's still in the progress. But 1 word for AP is that key revenue stream is the region with the whole. So EY definitely play the key players when it comes to revenue contribution and start all initiative in this region. So compared to other region who haven't started Heading for a Future, AP is the only region who implement all of the EY initiative. So which is something we should celebrate ourselves and we need to be proud of ourselves. What can we do more? How can make EY not only just the engagement, but also the EOD support? Because definitely we can see some of the entity that use the EY to contribute, get more membership. They use EY to contribute more people want to join the GT program. They use EY to contribute to more people understand about GP. In the future, they can go for GP. So thinking about EY, not only just engagement, because no matter what, back to the Isaac Ansons and the core we are going to do is about leadership development program. So no matter what, how can we be more connecting about young people can connect more about Isaac, and also they are interesting to join Isaac, be part of ISA members, or even join ISA program. So these are key topic. I was also challenged with AP, how we can move these things forward. Secondly, how we centralize from MC level to a current initiative, because we can see so many LC, they do their own initiative and then do their lots of like the things there. But still like the, if you want to ensure the direction is clear and straightforward, things should bring back to MC. So how can we button up to collect some LC initiative who run it well, who run they can improve based on the validation? We give the LC suggestion, some initiative you can continue running for it. Some initiative you're just burning money, burning HR, but it didn't take any contribution result. Need to adjust for it or remove it. How middle and small player can learn from the region regarding EY initiative? This is something also we are going to do in the global direction. So I know some of the entity you try 1 year to do lots of EY initiative, you try to implement, but after 1 year, still nothing. But it's not your fault. It's not like the you don't have the proper knowledge or proper brand. For sure, we are at ISA, we should engage more of the talented young people in this organization already. But the major thing is that you have lack of resources, lack of the preparation, lack of HR. That's why the implementation will take more time. But maybe it will be easier. You can start to learn from other entity, other region, how they implement the National EY Initiative, or even current youth speak and Heading for the Future to make it easier to moving forward about your direction you want to push. So moving back here, we are going to talk about current global EY global direction. These are two things we are keeping in mind. And also we still have lots of like the clarity need to bring in out, but still these are the thing we'll bring into AI replanning, and then we'll release more about EY, what can we improve as a program. So first of all, we're talking about National EY Initiative. And second, we'll talk about Heading for a Future and just the progress in the global plenary. And final, we'll give you a suggestion about how entity you're prepared and get ready to running for this EY program. First of all, EY GCP project. So every month, on 18th of every month, and by end of, by 5th of every month, we'll start the period about collect the EY GCP. So if, 18th to 1st of every month. So we will do this like the quality review by EY team, and also after we collect all the GCP, we can validate about it, And also like the, we will collect all the inputs. If we definitely see some of the entity, you do have a GCP and have a huge contribution, huge market potential to make the EWA become our official GCP. And six of every month, we will launch the GCP recognition. So maybe some of the entity you submit the EWA GCP, but maybe in the final, you didn't recognize as the official GCP not recognized in the gold plenary. We'll also give you a feedback about how you can improve it, or even you still can run it for it. It doesn't mean that if you are not recognized a GCP from global plenary and then you cannot run this program. You still can run for it, but we'll also give you some suggestion about how we see these can be a GCP. Maybe this, the reason why you're not selecting as GCP, maybe it's because this program can only downscale in your entity. The context is not relevant to other region or other entity. Maybe your GCP didn't contribute a huge market value, but it's still the engagement of initiative. So this is additional encouragement. The objective behind of it is that we want to encourage the network they can understand and submit of it. After that, we create a global learning space and also how we implement the EWA in a much more easier way. Imagine some of the EWA program can downscale in other entity. So yeah, these are the criteria we're looking for. Initiative, business model canvas, key activities, brand elements, and also agenda. So based on these all the framework and the guidelines, after we validating, we'll also give you some feedback. It should be recognized or not recognized, and what's the reason behind of it. So yeah, the activity program and about the EWA phase tied to our core as organization. The EWA initiative must have a component of introduction of ISA. The EWA initiative should have financial planning and a result for positive ROI for the entity. Final, the EWA initiative should direct the participant attend toward EOD program. So these are the four criteria we're looking for the EWA GCP. So final thing, so what we're going to do, every 18, we'll still launch in the global icon. So for current MCP term, they'll start to submitting and also to push their EWA GCP. And for us, we'll keep validating on there. For ELAC, you just be aware of once we launch the EWA GCP in the global network, no matter in the ICOM or even the newsletter, you can look into it. If you see some like the framework is interesting, you can start to launch in your entity. You can raise out a conversation with the entity or raise out a conversation with the MCP ELAC, with your team, how we start to initiate this program rather than we do the innovation and researching in the beginning stage. So yeah, that's the first thing. And secondly, when it comes to EWA network service in the way forward, we still deliver the global EWA call every month. This month we don't have because we have the regional functional summit and in each region, such as America, Euro, MIA, and AP. And Euro, MIA, and AP will collaborate together. It will happen on 24th to 26th. So you can take a note, the program we're engaging will be BD, EWA, marketing, GB, and GT, both OJS and ISAs, GB, and GT. So this program, we are doing the RFS by end of the month. So for entity, you have done the planning, no worry. You can still send your NCVP there to understand about global contacts and all things, how they can bring back to the entity. So these are the network service still delivered every month. And every month, we also open consultancy for network service. So for example, we have EWA GST heading for a future GST, and also each region will have one GST responsible for national EWA initiative. So every month they are open a consultancy support and open their blogs. So your MCVP can also book the call with them. So we also announced in the Slack channel and the Telegram channel to let MCP know about this. So the support from the network share GCP and the project report attending the global and network course. That's all for the national EWA initiative. Secondly, we are looking for heading for a future. So heading for a future is like the program we're still running for eight. Right now we have AI, have a global heading for a future, as in India, as in Sri Lanka, as in Australia, as in Argentina, and as in Cote d'Ivoire. These are entities that join the focus group and also want to contribute some inputs and also the evaluation, the learning about heading for a future. So these are the focus group. For entity, if you plan to run for next phase, right, you can still join the consultancy or book the call with Lina, because Lina will also open for you if you are considering running for heading for a future. So these are something you can keep in mind. And I hope these like the older program when you consider running for it, you can still consult my GST to understand about current context and how can you improve as the way forward. Moving to the next is about USP. So USP, as you can see in last global legislation, we're trying to make the USP in much more easier and also much more flexible phase. So right now we are also in the validation phase. We are already finished a USP survey, like the collection from global plenary. And right now we have focus group analysis contributed by as in Greece, as in Mexico, as in Peru, and as in Vietnam. So these are entities that are still running for GSP, and we are also trying to collect their input and what is the insight from their side, how we improve our GSP. So right now I will say there's no really strong restriction and also all the limitation when you're running for GSP, but you still can use the previous framework. But in IC, we'll have a definitely like some change management when it comes to GSP. Should we centralize from global plenary based on global timeline, or you'll be decentralized and you can run by themselves. But no matter what, we still will provide guidelines and a support when you're still running, run for GSP in the current phase. So yeah, this is something we are also going to do. And the way forward for MCP, if you still want to know about the GSP framework we're having right now, you still can book a call with my MCVP, my GST, like a GSP, so she can bring you some context and understand everything. So yeah, that is a key update here. Two things reminder for MCP you can keep in your mind. For entity who are running for EY for a long while, you already have lots of the EY initiative coming for entity, you're running for heading for future in GSP. First, follow EY principle. These are the major minimum you should follow, because no matter what, if you didn't follow, you also affect about your brand awareness and also how you promote to your customer what they are interested in as in the right way. Second, ensure your EY initiative with gross profit margin. Based on the last EY, like the financial data in AP, none of the entity running, like the really few entity run for revenue from EY. So this is not a huge problem. We are coming from there. So how we monitor the budget, how we monitor execution, ensure that EY is not only engaged to more people, but also we have a revenue generated from there. Looking to the key measurement for EY to EOD conversion. This is also another thing I will recommend you. You can look into the EY to EOD conversion that help you can bring more content and how it can bring forward. For entities who plan to start running the EY initiative, highly recommend you start to run by heading for a future in GSP and join the global network service. So understand the current framework, followed by the current framework, it'll be much more easier rather than start for innovation. Can also learn from your regional commission from the EYGCP and start to conduct and follow your MCVP learning from academy and before planning begin. Finally, so these are the framework and tools you can start to look into. First is MCP Transition Toolkit, and the following links, all the materials, all the things is already there. So if you do have your MCP, do have any questions, you can let them know. These are the materials I'll be having EY, so they can also directly learn from the academy and bring back what is the input and the things you want to have. But no matter what, just keep in mind when you start to implement the EY, it will be better to follow the current framework, because right now it's in the post-pandemic phase. Most of entity that start to resuming GV start to running for GT and the current EOD operation. So it doesn't make sense that you're still driving the 1 year innovation and trying to conduct one of EY initiative, but something is not relevant for current context. So that might be the potential risk, just keep in mind. But it doesn't mean that we'll not encourage you doing the EY innovation. It depends on your network native. It depends on your entity needs, how EY can contribute to your organization growth and also your performance growth. So these are something you can keep in mind, and also to generate more the ideas. If something is relevant, still can run for it, but take it into consideration by your HR and financial wise. So yeah, this is all of the EY keynote I want to talk with the current state. Before we end, let me check. Okay, let me start the screen sharing, and then yeah, feel free, if you have any question, you can start to ask it here. But also if you want to have a link, you can directly also let me know. Let me send the link to all of you right now. Give me a second. Any question? Hold on, I'm also finding a link to you. Okay. If no other question, you can give me the wave in the chat and I will be understand all clear about your information. Also, this is the EY slides, after this keynote, you can still check the all the material and also read all the context there. Cool. If no other things, yes, this session today, we are not only talking about the EY, the keynote, but also we are going to talk about the planning preparation. So moving back to our key topic, which is planning, pre-planning. So I just want to have a quick sensing, how much have you already done for the planning, or even you can give me some emoji. For example, if you are all good, you're all on the right track, you can give me the thumbs up like this. If you say, what is planning? Oh my God, I don't know. You can give me this emoji, you're crying with the out loud with the laugh. And oh, we have planning material. Oh, we need to do planning. You can also give me this one. Any emoji is allowed. So you can show an emoji. Let me do a quick sensing about how confidence you're having with your planning, current planning stage. Okay, Nisha have a, okay. Raghav have thumbs up. Thomas have thumbs up, which is good. Sumi have thumbs up. I know some of you are still like trying to, oh, Kaneel, so you don't know you need to do planning, right? Okay. All the best, bro. Let me know. I will stay in like the Sri Lanka for 2 days. Let me know if you're on salary support, but I know you're getting that. No worry. Like I know like some of you still haven't selecting all of your team, but no matter what, planning preparation is a must, and also you need to prepare first. No matter you in the future, what kind of structure you'll change and how many people you'll recruit there, always keep it flexible, but you need to have a whole idea and a whole like the whole picture about how you're going to work about your planning. So yeah, we can start about the planning session. In 3, 2, 1, start podcasting. I'm sharing my screen right now. Cool, let's start our planning. Nori, later on we have some working space for all of you together, so you can start to look into the material and also how you're taking everything there. So first of all, I will still introduce myself. My name is Tony. I'm currently like the AI AP and UI Operation Manager. Why I need to introduce myself again, but no worries. Yeah, right now I'm based in India, and like the still originally our regional office is in Colombo, Sri Lanka. But right now we're going to move to another place. We'll let you know soon. In summer, we're going to move in other amazing place. Just briefly to share my past experience, and also before that, let me introduce my previous ED body Preo and say hello to everyone. the Elect NCP. Hi. All the Elect NCP.
Hi everyone.
Yeah. Congrats. Yes. Thank you, Preo. Yeah. Right now I'm in Preo's office because she offered me some good working environment there. So really appreciate how Isaac connecting with Diaphone connection. Anyway, so looking back here, let me introduce my previous experience. I was LCVP OGB, TN and LCP. After that, I joined the GV, like the GCDP experience in ASEAN, Tanzania. So that's my first experience in Africa, East Africa. After that, I become MCVP OD and MCP of ASEAN, Taiwan, and then become RMED for ASEAN, Asia Pacific. So all of my journey, I really wish to do a product, but my NCP always told me you are good in the OD and somehow. So that's the reason I allocated in the back office function. But it's okay, right now I'm running E1, I'm still happy about it. But looking back to the planning, that's also a reason why I really feel connected, especially for planning preparation. So the objective for this session, you will understand about energy direction and process by different planning frameworks. You'll embed the planning into ISA. You'll know how to prepare my team and also understand about build the agenda by knowing the direction you want to drive. So starting from the plan RPN session for planning, we'll divide into 3 parts, pre-planning, during planning, and post-planning. So in pre-planning, we'll give you the whole idea about planning onboarding and a pre-planning reminder. In during the planning, you'll manage your planning and also planning principle and why data orientation is important. Final in post-planning, why is the post-planning and why? Stakeholder in post-planning, how to downscale your plan, how to use your chair and our support timeline. So these are the whole thing. We'll also give you some whole idea about before, during, and after. So right now you are in the pre-planning phase, which is phase one. So you can start to think about how you prepare about your planning in the current state. But before we move into pre-planning, why do we have the planning in ISAC? That's the most important topic. Planning is preparing the sequences of action and steps to achieve some specific goals. So I think looking to the definition of planning, this is definitely something you need to figure out, and also you need to think about how planning can contribute yourself and also your energy direction. Planning is a map. So if anything without planning, you know what you don't know what the direction look like. You don't know how you achieve the direction by this step, step by step, and also through your milestones. And also, planning is important to prepare to achieve the goal, sequences of action steps to achieve something, and final thing, help to save time and effort to achieve what we want. So last reason, planning is really important. And we do have amazing planning experience, and also we do have some bug out experience. So and planning is like a map. So every time we search on Google, Google, please tell me what is the planning, I beg you, and how can we plan with post-pandemic change management, etc. But yeah, every time you find it, there's always arrows. You cannot find anything on there. And also you always feel lost about how to do the planning and all things there. But make everything okay. No matter what, like the it's still okay that you can still make it calm and also have all the previous material that you have and also all the things like that you can settle down and also get ready for your turn. So still, these are the reason why we also have some framework and tool will help you to linkage and connect into your future direction. The concept of planning does not change anything. This is your dream, what you dream want to achieve as MCP. So that's the reason why it's also important for yourself to dig in and considering about how you achieve your turns to achieve your milestone you want to drive. And think about MCP instruction. Are they connected? Based on your current structure, your plan, you already recruit. Based on your personal motivation, when you go on the NCP election, go on the stage and share what's the direction you want to drive. Are they connecting all the things you want to drive in current stage? Let me tell you a quick story about what happened when I started my MCP turn in Tiana as a regional office. So yeah, this is my fancy photo, like we always in our MC term, every year we take the fancy photo and like the group photo together. So starting from MCVP OD in 1819 term of Isaac in Taiwan, our MC identity is called MC Infinity because we only live once. So we try to fulfill everything in the planning. We always remember like the, in globally, we downscale lots of the tools, lots of the sheet we need to manage, we need to work on, but it turns out we have too many focus we want to do and what we want to drive. So that's the reason why we always like to have really like have a huge difficulties. And also like the, we have lots of like the challenge to downscale and fulfill there. So I always remember our planning experience first time is really overwhelming. We have so many things to do. We have 10 projects in each of the people, but by the end of the day during the replanning, we only fulfill one or two projects. So that's the reason I realized we need to downscale and make it easier. But when it comes back to MCB 1920 of Taiwan, yeah, this is me. So they use some Photoshop to make me thinner. So yeah, that's the reason why I came into this shape. But no matter what, like the looking to my MCB experience, I starting to realize one thing, because that is the last year of ISA 2020. We don't have a future direction. At that moment is also another really important phase. We have a president election. The young people in Taiwan, or even like the young people, yeah, the young people in the whole society in Taiwan, we shape like the, it's kind of a dilemma, because either you write for first party or you vote for second party. So that's a huge like the challenge that we look into Isaac and all the things comes up. So it's the generation around, not only just Isaac, but the turning point of Taiwanese society and also the Isaac. So that is also the key challenge for me a lot, how we can figure it out the future direction we want to drive in the future. We plan a 3 years milestone, we want to strive for the ambition and also to become the top choice leadership organization in Taiwan. So these are the planning output after we have a whole conversation to dream about what us in Taiwan can be. We map out the 3 years milestone we want to drive. But still, we have lots of initiative ambitions, but we realize some projects didn't work out in the middle of the term. I know we are trying to downscale, we're trying to reduce the project to 3 or 4. We're trying to make sure we can be more reasonable, like the goal setting, but still, it still have some challenge when we build other things and all things come up there. So I cannot say our ambitions to still really drive the right, really drive the good result, but we always thinking about how this planning was supporting the energy to growth and also to dream together. And I'm happy about my success. I also bring the 3 years milestone to moving forward in the next generation. Becoming RED 2021 in Asia Pacific, this is something I realized we see this experience as a learning. So I won't say all my previous planning are shit. Maybe you can look it back about your LCB experience, LCBB experience, even your MCB experience. You definitely always see some improvement from your MD level. And we start to know how important planning can make the impact and change it to an MD. So these are the nutrition for myself, how planning is really important, how they can lead all experience to contribute in the future. Another thing I also to realize, make sure you have a planning preparation around 2 to 3 weeks. Ensure all of the NCVP prepare all the contacts. Once the fulfill preparation, they can definitely contribute and also fulfill them and understand what's the direction they want to drive in the future. So yeah, if you have a goal and you have a people, you just need a direction and the resources. That's the reason why we need to do the planning here. So yes, that's official to become our planning onboarding. The objective of the planning, the MC planning process based on ISO 25 direction, connecting to the revenue diversification and entity priorities. So these are goals we still want to drive and to build all the sustainable entities there. The planning framework is to provide the direction and the resources to the entity to prepare, plan, and achieve their goals. Disclaimer, this is an entity planning, not a recovery plan. The network is not obligated to use all the tools and resources provide. So maybe you'll think about later on, you still see lots of the planning framework and tools there. But no matter what, you need to ask your question first about what do you want to drive your turn? What do you want to achieve by the end of the turn? These are the major important things you need to keep in mind. So yeah, based on the planning flow you can see here, we have MC team building, content analysis, focus selection, goal setting, strategy building, accountability system, network management, and finally risk management. So in today, we are going to check again. Today we are more talking about MC team building and content analysis because that is the starting point you need to look into here, and also how you can look into the context and how you build as the way forward. So example, like the previous use, like the, maybe you know about some planning framework, for example, developing your strategy and playbook, So like the these are the play to win. So winning inspiration, where to play, how to win, capability, management system. So these are the previous one where you might have a curiosity about this. Second, it will be like the 4DX model, and finally will be OKR. So maybe you can let me know what kind of the tool you use. You can tap in the chat. Maybe you use play to win. Maybe you use 4DX. So like the discipline 1, 2, 3, and 4 connecting to the final, like the planning output, how you connect it back. Or you use OKR, you have objective, you have key resource, you have initiative. How do you get your team have the same aspiration, want to drive together? But no matter what kind of plan, right? Still, we also have some transition pool, like the tool and transition framework and supporting you. We also have some planning framework can help you to understand everything there. In the visual present meeting, we also have some capacity building for planning. So don't need to worry about it. Something to keep in mind. This is an energy planning, not a recovery plan. And based on the NDI priorities and revenue diversification, the output expect is about operation focus, revenue distribution, goal setting, and strategies. Some support is about team building, context analysis, accountability, and network management. So these are the basic principles when we look into planning. Yes, here we come. We are going to have a planning preparation. So in a planning process, planning preparation is about the resource. We have general, innovation, sales materials, and maybe planning. And you can check this link here. So ais.ec/MC2023 preplanning. So these are all of the material you can use in there. And you will have a, what will you have in the planning preparation? You will have external context analysis, internal context analysis, functional context analysis, talent context, and network mapping. And also in these slides, you can also see some of the supporting material that can help you to understand how you bridge out a better plan and also how you're supporting like all the plan that you can bring forward. And adventure time. So these are all the material you will have, right? And before we begin, right? Later on, I will also give you some instructions. So for some of the people, maybe you don't have an NC planning experience before, no worry. I will onboard you one by one about each supporting materials. You won't feel lost and also you don't need to worry about this. But for some of the NCP, you already knew what you're going to do. So then you can directly discover all the preparation tool and the planning tool what we have, and also how you can align to your planning, like the implementation when you started to do your planning. So first you can explore the folder and also do self-onboarding. And right now I want to distinguish two types of people. First of all, I have no clue about the global tool. So you can stay here for onboarding for 10 minutes. I know what to do, let me work. So if you know like, oh, in my NC planning, we also follow this framework and tool we're going to have. Later, I'll directly give you the working space. You can digest all the tool and you can still leave the question. If you do have a question, you can also let me know. And I know what to do and let me work based on these people. We have different types of group of people, but I know today we have a few people. We don't have all the MCBR here, but it's okay. So later on, we'll still divide into three breakouts, but depends on the breakout, like the people, how many people there, we'll do some change allocation. We'll divide into three breakouts. So maybe you can also help me settle down and later on people can choose their breakout. First, I have a minimum structure. I only have 4 to 5 MCVPs, and then people can join there. And also you can start to dig in your material and also to dig in your time to look into it. I have median team structure. So for people who have 6 to 8 MCVPs, and you can in this group, later on can talk together. I have huge structure, so it means there are more than 8 MCVPs in your team. So these are the people who have more structure and more like the even have management team and a sub team. So these are the people who can use a different way when you look into your planning. So yeah, later we're going to have adventure time, but in the beginning, we will separate these two breakouts first. First, you have no clue to about global tool, and another one just you can have an individual working space. So let me start sharing and moving back here. Give me a second. So yeah, Mary, I need your support, so you can give me one breakout so people you can just work in there. So can I have a quick sensing if you want to stay in the group chat? What happened if you have less than 4 MCP? Then it's okay, I can stay in a 4 to 5 MCP group, so don't worry about that. Yeah, we are left no people behind, so don't worry about this. So people, I want your quick sensing. So right now, if you want to stay in this room to onboard in the whole planning framework, you can give me this emoji. I think, let me know if I can have this emoji. Ah, no worry. Yeah, just follow what Nisha said. You can say stay here. You can say stay here and you want to go for your working time. You can type you want to have a working time. Okay. Oh my God, it turns out many people, everyone will stay here. But I mean like, because it's also for your time you can discover and also to dig in the tool. So don't worry about this, but you can also have a basic understanding about here, all the things here. So stay here. Okay, so Mary, you can help me create a breakout. So just another breakout. Yeah, Mary, for sure, stay here. you can create a breakout, like the one breakout for personal working space for people. If they want to dig in their framework, they have 10 minutes to work there. Okay?
10 minutes?
Yeah, just 10 minutes. Cool, cool, cool. Okay. We can pause the recording. So let's do take some time and learn for portfolio understanding. You definitely need to define your program, your product, and your initiative. So first is about your portfolio, what you have in group of the portfolio, and like the responsible person for who and run by MC or LC, and how this program look like and how you can improve as a way forward. So these are a series of guiding questions, starting from understanding your product and defining your target, competitor analysis, and also defining the resources required. So these are all the materials can also help you to understand about how you, what kind of the financial HR resources and the marketing potential can help you to downscale off it. So final contents consolidation to do some analysis. My recommendation this one, right? Because you need to copy it for each program. So it can also become your program task in each product management person. They need to duplicate and also do their own analysis first. After that, they can present it to the whole team. Like, oh, this is OGT, this is OGB, this is IGB. After presenting all of the portfolio understanding, then you do consolidation. So usually when we do a consolidation, we have impact and effort. So you can see the note here, they have a definition about low impact and high impact was the definition. So impact, it means that how much contribution and also how much can that be supporting your goal and direction. Effort, it means that how much capacity you need to test and also any like the risk and capacity you might have in the future team. So this will definitely also affect you a lot how you differentiate and prioritize of it. So after that, when you map out the score, you can definitely to map out what is the final consolidation from your part, from your entity direction, and then you finalize your program like the portfolio. So this is how like the portfolio looks like when you have in your team consolidation there. Final lining again. Final context conclusion. So it based on each context, right? So then what is the, I think we'll remove this one. This one, it won't have anything. Let me delete off it. Let me hide off it because I think this is just internal external context conclusion, but it's not relevant for current context. So finally, like you finalize like the context conclusion. So you will map in now, what will be your focus and portfolio like the when it comes to here. Is that clear or any question regarding like the portfolio management here? All clear? Thank you. Yeah, don't take your laptop for granted. Cool. So later on, I will give another 10 minutes conversation. So start like that. You can based on your group and also start the conversation based on the guiding question I sent into the Telegram group. So yeah, Mary, you can open for 10 minutes talk for the MCPs.
Yeah, the room is open. You can choose your room.
Thank you, MCP. See you.
Please choose the correct room.
Let me check. Can you also send me the screenshot of the question? It's not in the Telegram chat.
Oh, great.
Ah,
it's not okay.
We are sending, no worry, Raka. We are sending to there. Thank you so much, Mary. Dun dun. How many MC, like the people you will recruit or you have been right now? Like the Alicia? Like in total, sorry, how many people you have? Mm.
Total people as in MC?
Yeah.
What if I have none? Oh, okay. As in like, oh, okay, okay.
Yeah, but you can tell me which numbers. I can tell you which will be small and medium and large. They're huge.
You plan to recruit?
I want to recruit 7 people. Yeah.
7 people, then you can join the medium one.
Medium? Okay, okay, cool. Thank you.
See you.
See you. Bye.
I also send this one day.
Just like she said, what if I have none?
Let me know like the if people are back. I'm trying to get the context about why they are asking these questions.
Oh my god, Tony!
What happened ever to by myself or with Apple? So I know in the registration form, you're also filling in our sharing service support. So just let you know, our will start with sharing like the facilitation starting in June. And July, we're looking to some MCP current if that interesting day, and maybe they will become your chair because July will be the huge peak for our for planning and all things comes up. But I know some of the entity, you will start your planning in July. And work on the planning output based on the planning goals and strategies and upload the planning tools in our feedback in the phone. So we'll also give some feedback after the planning implementation. Wait for our feedback, then implement the feedback. And submit the ELD goals on XPI and other goals like the links in July. And something to keep in mind, don't leave planning to prepare in the last minute. Definitely. My replanning is planning last minute. It turns out so many dramatic things happen. But luckily I have a COVID, so I still keep changing that planning. But still better to have a proper planning preparation, all things comes up. Explore all the resources. It's important to understand the direction. Ask questions, clarify everything you need to know for planning before you start to prepare of it. Adapt into a reality. You should not just copy and paste and also put the customer in your tools to use in the planning. So last one, this one is really important, like the teamwork help. So I hope like the in the future, the MCP, you can bridge a small group just for planning purpose. You can also to share about what is the material I'm going to deliver together. A portion of regional office for questions, support, planning delivery, customization, etc. And they are here to support. We are here always to support your journey. So yeah, before we end of the planning, onboarding, any other question you might? Or anything you want to ask about planning preparation for your side? Apart from the bird check.
I have a question, if it's okay. For the whole planning, like I'm more about the output. Is there a specific way that RO wants us to have the output for MC planning, or is it free will?
Okay. I think after this session, I will send you the output presentation because right now we don't have a limitation for output, but in the past we have an output sheet and we can also use the previous slides about the output presentation. That's more, you can also use that tool, can directly present to your national conference when you launch your planning presentation. But yeah, these I'll keep in mind. I will send the output like the after today's session and also can take you in the reference. But in post-planning, we'll also have another check to talk about this.
Okay, cool. Thank you.
Thanks, Thomas and Nisha.
I think, so as you say that we can customize it, so it's okay that we don't use the same sheet. If we have time and if we can like tailor it for our like entity, then we can get it like checked by you and then we can follow it for the planning, right?
Yeah, exactly. Actually, like the least, all the tools are objectives to supporting you to create a direction and create a step, a flow and step to help your entity. But it doesn't mean that you need to follow because like if you have better tool, better idea, and it will be good to also have a conversation with the predecessor about how you lead your planning and moving forward or share with your similar group of entity to share some resources and tool are going to have. These can definitely help you to drive your direction, but no matter what, when we have a planning output like the framework there, you just need to know how your output can align to the framework and we can know how to give a feedback as the global direction want to drive. So any way is allowed, any way is possible. So you just need to customize to yourself and to downscale to entity, then it's all good. Thanks, Nisha and Iko.
Thank you so much.
Okay, my very first question, like when the chair would be, you know, announced to us because I request it and then like if we need to have some kind of follow-up and then like giving some kind of correction when you know the announcement of the chair for each entity.
Ideally will be after RPM we'll have another CEO for 90-day session. We'll launch by that moment because we're still mapping all the chair visibility. But based on the timeline what we wrote in the evaluate like the registration form, it should be start in the last week of May until end of June. Is that the period I can provide a service? And July, we will still look into like the you can have your predecessor to share, and then you don't need to RO, you can directly ask them to share the planning. So you can let them know. Because no matter what, right, we are not expecting like the all of the entity you should require RO to do sharing. Because like our just supporting material is too bad. Supporting system for you to like to help you to understand all things there. But if your planning period is not in this period, then I think based on timeline, we are not have a visibility to support a lot. So like the last reason why, like if it's not in this period, just text me. I can follow up with you about everything. But apart from this, we'll release by around 17. It's the another CEO for 9-day session.
I see.
But equal your planning is earlier, right? So you can text me personally. I can check with me any feasibility or possibility. So you can keep in mind if we cannot provide. So like you can start to search other possibility. Maybe. I can give you some recommendation.
Okay. Thank you, Tony.
Cool. It will be around 17th of May. It will be after RPM. We'll have another CEO for 9-day session. At that moment, we can do some chair allocation and then you know who you should follow and who will be your planning consultancy. Because even though if you're not required hour for chair, right, you still can receive the service from ED. They can give you some planning consultancy. You can also ask questions to ED people there. Cool. Any other questions? Cool like a pool. If everything is okay, then yeah, I think we can close the session. But before we end, we still have something important to do. So Mary, can you help me share the screen? That'll be more easier and we won't waiting for too much time. So yes, something familiar, always the harvest learning and also feedback. So first you can take some time. I'll give you one song. You can finish the harvest learning debrief. I'll also cross-check about it. And also another one is feed forward. So like the Mary can also put a shorter feed forward sheet there. Yeah, the strawberry one. Okay, you can attach a link first. Yes, so also don't forget to give us about the feedback because we can know how to improve the session. Every year, we also always have this session. So we can know how to improve and also understand all the context there. So yeah, I will give you one song so then you can start to working on it. I will cross-check about your harvest learning and everything. Or Mary, if you can help us play one song, that'd be amazing.
You booked the night train for a reason, so you could sit there in this hurt. Bustling crowds are silent sleepers, you're not sure which is worse. Because I dropped your hand while dancing, left you out there standing, crestfallen on the landing. Champagne problems, your mom's ring in your pocket, my picture in your wallet, your heart was glass, I dropped it. Champagne problems. Told your family for a reason, you couldn't keep it in. Your sister splashed out on the bottle, now no one's celebrating. Dom Perry on, you brought it, no crowd of friends applauded. Your hometown skeptics called it champagne problems. You had a speech, you're speechless. Love slipped beyond your reaches, and I couldn't give a reason. Champagne problems. Touch on the Chevy door, November flush and your flannel cure. This dorm was once a madhouse, I made a joke, well it's made for me. How evergreen our group of friends, don't think we'll say that word again. And soon they'll have the nerve to deck the halls that we once walked through. One for the money, two for the show, I watch you go. Sometimes you just don't know the answer till someone's on their knees and asks you. She would have made such a lovely bride. What a shame she's fucked in the head, they said. But you'll find the real thing instead. She'll patch up your tapestry that I shred and hold your hand while dancing. Never leave you standing, crestfallen on the landing with champagne problems. Your mom's ring in your pocket, her picture in your wallet. You won't remember all my champagne problems. You won't remember all my champagne problems.
Okay, yeah, I think time almost up and some people already done like the all the things and all the like the feedback there. So yeah, thank you, Mary. We can stop sharing the screen and we can end the synchronized earlier. And then yeah, like the, we can close this part. All the best. This week is RPN. I hope can see.